Dear ladies and gentlemen, colleagues, today we continue our series of meetings with the founders of the companies in IT, sports, technology, leaders on the market. Today we are welcome Marco Savino, founder and CEO of Interpro. Interpro is the first business intelligence solution that will improve football management. A few words about the process today. It's going to take 30 to 40 minutes in total. If something not clear, please write your question in YouTube chat. You can also always get in touch afterwards. Dear Marco, please say hello.
Thank you, Dennis. Thank you, Dennis, and Masterclass to host me today. It's a pleasure also to give you, to throw back about our background as a company. So as a founder, of course, every story about the startup starts from the founder story. So every time I tell about the product and about the business, I always start from my background and from the roots of the business. So to do this, we need to throw back to 2011, when I literally left my hometown. As you can see, I'm still quite young, even if the company is going well and is going, we did quite a lot of work. In 2011, I was at that time a professional athlete. I was a kayaker, so I was working in sports, and I was a pharmacist. So I don't come from the football industry. But at that time, I moved from my hometown to Milan. I had the chance to meet a professor that was my mentor during my career. And at that time, he was working as a sports scientist at Manchester United. So it really opened a new world on my professional life. And it took me to UK and introducing me all the technology, the best technology providers. And at that time, I was very passionate about technology, about physiology, because I was a pharmacist, and of course applying the technology to the real life, so to the sport. So I started to work in football. I started to work in football first as a data scientist, and I was analyzing mainly GPS and performance data, and then I became kind of, let's say, sports scientist / fitness coach. I was the guy who was trying to make sense of all the data coming from different technology reporting to the coach. And during my, now it's 9 years, between 9 and 10 years I'm working in football, in professional football. And the first 6 years they were on the pitch. So I was working with the coaching staff, and I was lucky because I changed a lot of countries and the different environment, different ecosystem. And I learned how to work even with different resources in terms of budget, because I've been working in top clubs, I've been working in average clubs. So really depending on the resource that was available at that time, we were developing, of course, our way to work in terms of integrating technology, and because of course it takes a budget to do that. And at that time I was really struggling because, and I guess that some of the people connected to that will see themselves in my words, because it's not just about my story, because it's a company that's been founded starting from a real issue. So I'm not the IT guy that provide a super smart system for football prediction, but I built, and we built, because we have a team, of course, we built a system working side by side with the football practitioner. And at that time, as I was saying, I was struggling a little bit, because after my 5-6 hours of analysis of my perfect Excel pivot, I was going to report to the coach or to the head of medical or to the CFO, sometimes to the CEO or sporting director, depending on what kind of information I had to report. But I noticed that they were not really understanding what I was saying, because I was carrying on very complex analysis. And we have to understand that when we have to deliver the message, it's not about mathematical skill or complexity, but it's about simplicity. And at that time, I understood that one of the main problems in football, in professional football, is the communication. Because The football club is very wide organization and has very different professional profiles in terms of professional background, academic background, but also cultural background. So you have people with a very vertical football culture, such as the coaching staff, and especially the head coach, and most of the time is a former player. Then you have a sports scientist and performance side, medical side, scouting, administration, finance, and of course all the complementary department. But the thing is that all those amazing professionals that work in football, sometimes they miss efficiency in communication. Because, of course, the coach doesn't have the tool and the background to understand the medical report, as the medical department doesn't have the tool to understand, like, a feedback from the coach, football-based. So sometimes, I was a kayaker, so we always say that if you don't paddle all together in the same direction, the boat keeps spinning. But it's a quite significant example because sometimes the same thing happens also during our daily work. So that was the first issue, and I say I need to fix this because this is something that it really will change my way to work. I will save time, I will save money, stress, and the most important thing, I will be impactful. So I will have an impact on the training process, because at the end of the day, the decision maker is the head coach and he does the training. So all the staff is like a supporting staff for who takes the decision. And if we support them in the right way, of course, they're able to take better decisions faster and also, of course, sometimes the right decision in short term, but also on the middle and long term. So this was the first issue. The second one, when basically I was working on the pitch and it was my second assumption that everyone is thinking about football just like performance, you know, athletic performance, 11 player against 11 player, who score more, one goal more, win the game. But it's not just about that, because actually, let's say that 60%, the revenue to wage ratio for an average club is about 60%. So 60% of the revenue are spent about the players, so about the contract. And if we add another 20% of that, I say 20, 15, maybe something more for a few clubs during the transfer market window, during the winter and the summer, it gets up to 80, 85%. So that means that 85% of the finance asset of the football club is represented by the players. So even if I'm a physiotherapist, I'm a fitness coach, or I do any like daily operation that sometimes that doesn't look like that impactful, I'm taking a business decision because I'm taking a decision about the players. So the real transition that we tried to push at that time, and I was elaborating the concept of Interpro, was like to bring the football to the next level, because I was coming from other industry and I saw that the football during the last 30 years was a little bit outdated, and I was trying to keep up with other industry, trying to apply all the new technology, amazing technology that are around the world at the moment. And so that was the perfect time. And so I say, okay, I need to build a platform. And to build this platform, this platform has to have like three main characteristics. The first one has to be super easy and super catchy. And I'm telling you this because the team that now is Interpro team, IT team, it comes from the gaming industry, because at that time I wanted a product that replicate the experience of the gaming. I was, you know, like, I guess, like all my all the people of my same generation age was playing Football Manager and FIFA at that time. And I took a lot of inspiration from the gaming industry. So I say, why that we are a professional, we don't have a tool like that. It's so easy to understand and so easy to reporting, and also to connect all the dots between, let's say, within the club. And so I say, okay, let's take the developer has to be super catchy. The second thing I say, we need to transform data into information, because I was so fed up that all the time I could not report to my decision maker, to my boss, actually, because all the time it was about the numbers. So I had to explain the numbers. But what if the number became information? That's the transition between any athlete management system or any technology, and an intelligent system, a smart system. So that gives you information ready to be used on daily basis. So this was the second characteristic. And the third one, as I say, was I wanted to build something. I really wanted to build a product, a solution that connects all the dots within the football club. Because it's easy to perceive sometimes that headquarter, you know, the pitch side and the off the pitch side or the board, they are very distant in terms also of the way to think. And this is right, but of course, in terms of managing all the operation and managing all the daily process, of course, there it should be there some connecting line. The way we founded the company was the time we founded the company, actually we started the project, was about 2015, so it was basically 5 years ago. And at that time I was going back from New York, and I had to say the US is a quite vibrant place in terms of for investors and for entrepreneurs, so it gave me a lot of confidence and courage to start this venture. I went back to Italy, I went back to Italy, to Milan, and we started to build in secret this product. And this lasts for almost 3 years. And we validate the system. It was very hard work with the team because it's an enterprise system. So we really touch all the aspects. It's a very huge solution. We started to build this with one of the most important clubs in the history of football. And you can see that on our website, any research you do. I'm not here to show off. I'm here to tell the story. And that feeling was great because, as I said at the beginning, this is not a product that is being built from the IT department and then it's been delivered to the final user. No, it's been built with the user. The first user, of course, was me in my position. Then I went to the medical side. Then we went to the coaching part. And we during this journey, was amazing because we really exchanged feedback with the clients. And our clients then become friends. And at the same time, they're really adding value both to the company and we add that value to them because we try to build the best solution. But it's always a back and forth and a dynamic relationship. And during this journey, for example, a lot of nice things happen, and you really know amazing person in football. And one of these person, of course, that I knew when I was working in Milan is our brand ambassador, which is Franco Baresi, maybe the best defender that ever stepped on a football pitch in the history. And for us, that moment was, of course, a turning point because when a player with that kind of experience and that kind of know-how about the football see your solution and really embrace your project and they decide to become brand ambassador, for us was like, great, okay. Okay, we got it. We have everything we need. We go out there and we can bring, of course, this revolution. We can make this revolution true. Since I was talking a lot about the solution, if Dennis allow me, I would like to share just to give you very, very quick, overview about the platform. So everyone is listening now can understand what is the business intelligence concept applied to football, which is very revolutionary. I think it's something that nobody saw it before, except on video games. So, sharing the screen.
Very interesting.
Sharing the screen, as you can see here, you see like our platform. So, of course, it's a B2B software, very complex and very structured because, of course, again, we touch a lot of aspects. But here, it's super catchy, as you can see. So everything, all the experience working within the software is super intuitive. So I will show you just couple of things. I'm not gonna if you want, of course, more information, I'm available to give it to you. But at this stage, I want just to show you the main concept. So this is the dashboard of the coach, of the coaching staff. And as you can see, there's no rocket science here. We don't want to deliver rocket science thing because we don't want to make it, we want to make the life of the people working on the software more complex than it is. So basically, again, the concept is improving the communication, sharing information. So the coach is super knowledgeable about football. Video analysis, match analysis, we got all of that, of course, but it doesn't have the tool, again, to really understand deeply the medical side, the performance side. So what we do, we deliver that information through a smart feedback. I guess everyone that is looking at the software already know about this concept, you know, very smart feedback, arrow up, arrow down, and it tells you the condition of the player, a little ambulance within the circle, and it tells you if the player is available or not, is injured or not. But the great thing is that you don't see number here anymore. All the number, you need to dig within the software, within the platform. Of course, if you are an advanced user, you can. But on the surface, there's information ready to be used. And those information are like in transversal way delivered to everyone within the club. And so the right information at the right time at the right person, but especially delivered in the right way. And this is just one example. On the pitch side, we can talk for the next 3 days about the software because it's huge, but I want to switch and go the one that you were seeing before was like the one we call the pitch side. And now there's the administration part. So as I say, during my speech at the beginning, you know, during my history, everyone is thinking about the football just as let's say a performance event, you know, like performance in terms of athletic performance. But it's much more than that. If an average club has to manage like 200, 300 million gross salaries, I cannot believe he can manage that through an Excel, or he can manage that with a system that is not contextual to football, because everything we know about football exists just for football. So this is another reason why our solution is at the moment is very vertical for football, especially the administration part and the tactical part, because it has unique characteristics. So here what we did, we say we need to get the finance on the software, but we need to bring the revolution on in the industry. How we did that? We are able to bring in contract to life. You upload your contract, any kind of bonus, option, and condition that come from the renewals to appearance bonus, performance bonus, whatever it is on the contract, and we're able to transform those in numbers in order to carry financial simulation for the entire team, but also for a single player. And it's crazy because this is something that I guess a lot of you that are listening at the moment knows, but a lot of you keep wondering how to do that. And the thing is that when we know how much is the cost for a club, about the player, of course, I'm talking about all the cash spent for that player since that player is at the club. And on the other side, we got like automatic integration. So like, let's say that 80% of the software is completely automatic. So you need to do nothing basically, because we get data from all the providers from the game and other technology providers from the pitch, from the training pitch, of course. We are able to see why you're losing money, if you're getting enough return on investment, and especially which is the residual. So in terms of why you're losing money, everybody's speaking today about injury prevention, the cost of the injuries, but no one is able to quantify that. So for the first time ever, we are able to do this because having like the financial data and having also the medical data and the minutes played during the official game, we can cross those data and create a proper intelligence system. And think about this kind of information in the pocket of a sporting director, of the CEO. We're not going to replace him, because the experience is very important in football. I mean, people are very experienced, and without them, we cannot carry on the same quality of work. But the experience has to be supported by a data-driven structure, a data-driven approach. Of course, data are not written in the rock, but it supports the decision. And of course, this is the main part, and like as every bonus is in the contract, we can literally track every bonus of the player and know when the player has to be paid, when another club has to be paid, when an agent needs to be paid, and even when we need to receive money in terms of software. So I won't go farther this because I really don't want to go too much into the product, but it's about the mission. A solution like this is a revolution because you need to imagine, you need to envision a scene like you walking within a football club, having a screen on the wall and people going around with a tablet or with a mobile, with a smartphone, with all the information about the player just at their fingertips. I am working in football. I need to get information about the player, the historical information, because that's my richness. I mean, that's what's the data are gold, but the data needs to be leveraged to be gold. Otherwise, they are just numbers. So I will stop sharing the screen, going back to the, yes. Okay. And the other thing is that, Dennis, the other thing that we are really paranoid about is it's about bringing data to life, like really make sense of the data. Because again, I don't want to be out there. There's a lot of solutions. The market is super crowded, but we want to really make the difference. And the difference here, when we talk about a business intelligence system, a report is not business intelligence. And since most of the people coming working in football, they don't have experience in other industry, sometimes getting the difference between the two is tough. But intelligence means having all the information that you need at your fingertips in order to get value for the information. So not just an empty repository where you drop your data. And this is a journey that it's the product, but it's also about the people. It's not just about the product, because we founded the company in 2018 here in London. And even if we developed the things in Italy, and there was, of course, a strategic decision to move all the asset here, all the company here. But basically, the 2018 was, again, a very silent year because we were in stealth mode working with the top clubs in order to develop this solution. And, you know, you get to know all those big guys from the football industry. Some of them already know, but of course now it's changed a lot of things. And since I want to tell you this because the Iterpro is completely self-made. And I really didn't know what was a business plan until 5 years ago. And so the experience during this journey, it's very valuable because it always adds value from both from the business point of view, but also from the product point of view. So I was saying we founded in 2018. It was a very silent year. Then in 2019 February we launched the product on the market, and now here we are after 1 year of course to be on the market. And that's been a great journey for us. But I will. Since we spent 25 minutes, I think we have another 15 for the answer a question. So,
from my side, it's really interesting. I think this is the future, absolutely. And in this difficult time, to save money or to invest money very careful, or to looking for your investments and to analyze. This is absolutely the future. What we have to do in our industry next time? Absolutely. For this reason, only congratulations to your fantastic idea.
Thank you.
From my side, we have time. Maybe you can show, if possible, any special case. For example, I don't know. Maybe fantastic development in the last. I don't know.
Yes, sure.
It has no secret, of course, yeah? Any general...
There's no secret about
it. I like football. Maybe
There's no secret about Interpro, and this is a choice of the company in terms of way we approach also the market. And like, for example, another thing that we don't have black box algorithm. We have our patent algorithm, but everything is open, so everyone coming on the platform can see it, can customize it, can see where we started and where the number are coming from. And this, I think, this is very important in order to build that trust with the professional. And let me bring also some example about the way we apply the solution, because again, it's not just about the product. It's about the culture, because this is a tool. Then the difference is how you use the tool. And for example, of course, we have top clients such as AC Milan, and they are one of the biggest club in the world and winning club in the world. So it's very challenging, and it's they want like a structural solution. They aim at the top. Everything you do there. Of course, it's an experience in terms of corporate experience. Of course, then when you visit like smaller size club, it's completely different. It's completely different what they want. If they completely different how they want to apply the system. And this is something very interesting for us that we are, let's say, on the first person there, you know, on site, because you really understand also the difference of needs, and you understand how to fill this gap through your solution. Let me give you an example. There's like, for example, Interpro can be used, as you can see, it's modular, so you can build your own solution. We have like pre-built package, but of course, if you want the video analysis, you have the video analysis. If you want the medical part, you get the medical part. If you want the scouting, and so on. So, for example, like on smaller clubs, they want to take care, of course, about the first team. And because it's the most important one, as I say, most of the asset is there. But there's also like a long-term vision for like some club that has this kind of culture. And he wants to monitor all the academy work in order to do some quality assurance about the technical work and tracking the player during their journey to spot the talent ID. And when we have all those kind of data on the same platform, of course, after 3-4 years, you want to check what's the path of the player. It's much easier to pick up, to cherry pick your talent, you know, within your academy. Of course, we do that internally. We don't do that outside of the club. There's amazing company out there that are doing this kind of job. But the other thing, since I name other company, is that Interpro is a system integrator. So we can work basically with everyone, GPS company, provider, medical devices. We can just build an API and everything is integrated there. Because the other struggle that I had, and sometimes I forget to tell this because maybe it's not main, but as you say now, we need, in this moment, maybe the club needs to spend less money. So we provide a lot of services on the same platform. So if you sum all the product that you should buy, it costs much more than Interpro by itself. But at the same time, we allow them to get integrated because maybe the club has some data that is using since, I don't know, 10 years. It doesn't want to change that. For us, it's perfectly fine because the first thing is the need. And I cannot force a solution that it's not wanted by the client. Also because then you need to restart how to use the system. I cannot, you know, you build your eyes and your experience based on what you saw before. This is very important. This is very, very important for us. And the other thing is, instead, the third example that I can bring on the table is about the federation and leagues. That are very different way to think, and it's more about the football development and like a centralized system, not to control the clubs or of course the national team, yes, because they want to check the national team and the player of national interest. But regarding the leagues, is like they want to provide like a cutting edge services to the football club in order to save money from both. Of course, the performance side, but also the administration and finance. But at the same time, act like the organization that order everything. Okay, like to give like some standardized protocol of work, and that's a third level of application of InterPro that we just started. And I can tell you, we just signed with literally a few weeks ago with the federation. We'll come out on our marketing channel very soon. And it's very interesting, this, for us, because it means going not just to the professional, but like moving, applying the system also at academy level and school level. And when I talk about the academy, I'm not talking about the academy within the club. We do that already. The system can embrace like until 100 teams, I don't know, even more. The sky is the limit. But applying the system, like a structural system, even on the academy school that are related to the football club, but they are not the academy school or the football club, that's a real revolution. Because that means that with one click, you can literally scrape and cherry pick within like 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 players. And those data are not just the data from the provider, are the data from Sunday to Sunday. So those are very precious because nobody can get that. So you cannot buy through an API, and it's about the user adding those data or collecting those data through other technologies. So this is absolutely great. And let me tell you also the last thing about this, and I think this is very important. Like nowadays, we are in this unforeseen situation, and it's about a little bit crazy. But in the bad, of course, like in this bad situation, very bad situation, I think we should start to think about opportunities. And something that really changed. And I see, because we are very active, as you can see, on the market, especially these days. And I think that this pandemic pushed and forced us to change our paradigm of life in the next years, maybe. It's not going to last months. It's going to last years. So it's a long-term vision. And, of course, we are a digital product, and this is good for us, of course, but it's not about us. It's about the football industry, because this pandemic forced everyone to digitize, and so the digitization process is speed up, and also this cultural change speed up. And I think this is very important, because as we are doing a webinar remote, and of course we could be together now drinking a beer, but we still can do this in remote for the technology. And I think that this is the best step. Of course, if it was no pandemic, it was better. But I think this is the best step to start to make the club efficient. So again, business intelligence is not just the software, but again, it's people, process, technology. And that's the most important thing, because people have to embrace the vision, the process has to be there, because otherwise they cannot collect data, and the technology just lasts. Because sometimes we are founder, no? And we are on the market. We always tend to say, oh, we are the best, we do. Yeah, let's try to understand the real needs first. Let's start from upside down. I'm not selling, I'm trying to understand what you want. And then based on that, we develop the solution. So I am up to you. If you have any other question, I will be super happy to answer.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Marco. Fantastic story, fantastic presentation. Yeah, we have a few questions. It's nothing special, but you already told a few. Question from my side is interesting for me, because this is a question to founder, to your company working worldwide or Europe-wide. Yeah, I think so. I think Africa, you have clients, of course. Yeah, any special differences between, I don't know, clients in Italy and UK, maybe Germany, I don't know. Asia, United States, I don't know, what is special?
Yeah, definitely. That's a very good question, because at the beginning I thought that football can be divided by geographic area, you know, based on the culture. But it's not about that. I discovered that it's not about that. It's mainly about history of the club, culture of the people within the club in terms of working culture. And so I can say that 5 years ago when I started, I think that UK and Germany were a little bit ahead in terms of vision, And I think that today you can see that because they're growing very fast compared to the other leagues. But now is the level is quite the same because everyone is start to understand that this is very important in order to make things efficient and to start to think in a very business-wise way, you know. And I think the difference is, again, about the culture, because sometimes you go in a small club that doesn't have much resource, but they understand that a solution, even expensive, it can be very useful for them to save money on long term. You know, they have very long-term vision and a very successful vision. And sometimes you go in a big club, and since they have a lot of budget and resources, they don't care about spending or wasting, let's say wasting a bit of money. I mean, we're talking about millions, dozen millions, but again, the margin of error is much bigger for them. So it really depends about what you want to do. If you want to fill the gap with the top, or if you want to gain that centimeter to win, it's very different between the two. So again, it's about internally at the club more than geographically.
Good, good. They have our club in Belgium. I read it. Does Interpro also collect data from hardware for load management?
From heart rate, you mean?
Hardware for load management. I don't know, belastung management in Germany.
I missed your voice.
I can't connect it because this is a very, very important question. We will send it directly to you and you can answer it directly to Bart. Yeah, okay?
Okay, yeah, sure, for sure.
Okay. So, what is about, from my side, only for understanding, because you work with really important data, how safe is the data inside your system? Because, you know, it's very, very...
That's a big point. Dennis, thanks for this question because it's the question that everyone is answering. It's the hot topic from 1 year, but I think for any industry because with the new policy about privacy policy about the data, you know, GDPR, and I think that every company like us, yes. We had to do that, and we are very focused about the security because at the moment, of course, we try to work with the top, so Amazon, Microsoft, in order to get the same level of security, and that's the best thing for us, and because we have also a bit less responsibility, but again, everything is scripted, and we cannot really, and this sometimes it can be an issue, but we cannot access the data of our clients. And this is something that at the beginning I say to the guys when we build the software, I say, we need to be waterproof because if somebody comes to me, does a due diligence, I close the company the day after. So the system is there. If they want to open some access, I will go there or they will just give me a written permission, but I cannot access the database because everything is encrypted. So this is really, really important. And on top of this, we are literally implementing already now is on the system like two-factor authentication. So every like also the banking security system for accessing the platform, and we log the activity of every user because if you have some of the member of your staff that is still accessing the platform from another club. That's very harmful because it can really makes a big damage to the football class. So you can see, you can track all the user, and you always have the situation under control. That's very important.
Okay. What is your plan for, I don't know, for the next month and maybe for the next two seasons? What are you thinking? What do you have to do? Which obstacles you have? What is the future of your company?
Yes, so on short term, we're already doing something, and as you know, we were talking before the webinar. We just launched since 10 days a free trial offer for the next 60 days in order for everyone to access the platform and understand if that is the tool that they need, but also to help a little bit. And of course, we cannot do much, but it's our little bit of help for the industry. And of course, this for the next 2 years, and there's a big question tag, everyone has it, but as a founder, as an entrepreneur, I'm very positive. And as I said before, we have always to spot the opportunity even in the best situation. And when you're able to do that, I think that in this period of crisis, the best idea comes out. And if a business is solid during and survive this storm, after that, we'll see the rainbow. Because we already have all the, yes, exactly. I say we have all the characteristics to be there because we have total digital solution. And honestly, maybe not because me, maybe Interpro will not exist in the next 5 years. It won't be me, but it won't be somebody else. This is going to be a must. Everyone is going to have something like this in the club. So it's just a matter of time. We are a bit pioneer, but again, we are on the right path.
I already got orders from Hank. I know somebody tried to buy your company already. I don't know, big investor, maybe bank.
That's early to say. That's early to say. Let's say that we talk with a lot of investors, but at the moment we are solid. So let's keep seeing this. I mean, how it goes. Because as you know, for a company like us, and I'm learning this during the last 3 years, you know, I went through a fundraising stage already. We did fundraising once. And the thing is, I'm still learning. The thing is that in my position, we are pioneer. We have an amazing traction because already we have a client with that level, you know, top level, and even like small clients. So we really demonstrate that we validate the solution that we can be applied on everyone. And again, we are solid. We have the vision for the future. So at this point, or we just keep going by ourselves, and that's going to be challenging, but it's going to be very exciting. And, you know, just saying, okay, everybody, we keep going by ourselves. We don't want any investment and let's face the destiny. And the other part is, or maybe just with a smaller investor, of course, without acquisition. And then, of course, the big fish, the big player on the market, they are always monitoring the situation. And sometimes they come to you and say, okay, you leave the business to me. You keep working in the company because we like the team, we like the vision. But again, you lose the control, so you lose a little bit the mission, you know, the original mission. But I mean, at the moment, I'm open option, but I want to really see where we go by ourselves in the next few months, because I think this is going to be a crucial period.
Exactly. Yes. Thank you very much. To all of us, we will process all your questions you have left in the chat. Directly to Marco. Yeah, Marco, you can answer it, please. Yeah, to our guests.
If any, it's on YouTube, right?
Yeah, on YouTube. Yeah. Just a moment. I think it's on YouTube. But we will send it later. It's no problem. After it. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, sure. I will answer after it.
So. So, dear guests, please note our webinar this Thursday, the same time, 6 p.m. Central European time. Your colleague, Dalibor Zweck, CEO from ONS Football, is a really innovative video tool for coaches. And still healthy. And see you again.
Thanks, Dennis. Thanks for hosting us. Bye.
Bye-bye.